This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The Labour Party of the United States was a short-lived political party formed by several state-level labor parties upon the encouragement of Chicago Federation of Labor leader John Fitzpatrick. It was formed in the immediate aftermath of World War I, due in large part to deterioration in the condition of the country's workers due to the imbalance between static workers' wages and rapidly escalating prices for necessities and consumer goods. The party quickly sought to unify the forces of the country's industrial workers with the farmers' movement and cooperative movement, as the nation's farmers had also been hit hard by declining agricultural prices during the war years, and the economic interests of urban workers and rural farmers fell into alignment on July 13, 1920. The Labour Party merged with the Committee of 48 to form the Farmer Labour Party. Contents 1 History 11 Background 12 Formation 13 Merger 2 Conventions 3 Officers 4 See also 41 State Affiliates 5 References 6 External Links History Background. The aftermath of the First World War had the effect of producing, throughout the world, the greatest revolutionary wave seen since the revolutions of 1848. Regimes which had defined their time before the war were abruptly overthrown in Russia, Germany, Austria, Hungary and Turkey. Revolutionary nationalism spread throughout nations, such as the Poles, Finns and Irish, which had been subject to centuries of domination by the great powers. Even the greatest empire on the face of the planet was unable to escape the socio-economic effects of the war and its aftermath, as the United Kingdom's entire political system was turned on its head when Labour superseded the Liberals as the official opposition to Conservative government in 1922, and ascended to form a government themselves by 1924. The United States was not immune of the effects of the war or its aftermath. Upon entering the war, the prices of nearly every industrial product produced in the United States began to rapidly escalate, while workers' wages were kept static and the prices for agricultural goods paid to farmers went into decline due to overproduction. The Wilson administration, primarily interested in waging the war, began to favor management in the event of any strikes which occurred, and propaganda was disseminated labeling all who did not selflessly contribute to the war effort to be disloyal and un-American. Even worse, as the war ended, the economic bubble which it had produced burst and the United States was thrust first into the post-World War I recession, and then into the Depression of 1920-21. Against this backdrop, the farmers and industrial workers of America were beginning to respond to the pressures which they had been forced to shoulder beginning as early as 1915. The Nonpartisan League began to develop in North Dakota, and by 1917 the Union Labor Party was formed in Duluth, Minnesota. In 1918, the Minnesota arm of the Farmers Nonpartisan League merged with the Union Labor Party and the Workers Nonpartisan League to form the Farmer Labor Party of Minnesota. At the same time, a strike by the International Association of Machinists in Connecticut was evolving to create the American Labor Party, and the Chicago Federation of Labor was leading the charge to organize the Labor Party of Cook County in Illinois. Over the course of the next year, the Labor Party of Cook County and the Illinois Federation of Labor joined forces to help form the Labor Party of Illinois, while workers in New York City established the American Labor Party of Greater New York, which quickly evolved into the American Labor Party of New York State. By August 1919, labor parties had been established in 7 states, including Minnesota, Connecticut, Illinois, New York, Kansas, Ohio, and South Dakota. By November, labor parties would exist in all 48 states. Formation on August 18, 1919, representatives of the 7 labor parties convened the National Conference of Representatives of Labor Party Groups, where the parties agreed that they would establish a national organization of the Labor Party of the United States. They determined to issue a call to the first convention of the new party, which would be held on November 22 in Chicago. The call specified that the central bodies of the labor federations in each state would each be entitled to 1 delegate. The labor parties and individual labor unions would be entitled to 1 delegate for every 500 members, and the Nonpartisan League, Committee of 48, Social Democratic League and British Labor Party, among others, would each be entitled to send 1 fraternal delegate. The conference elected a temporary executive committee with former AFL presidential contender Max S. Hayes as its chair, and adopted Robert M. Bucks the new majority as the party's official newspaper. The convention met, as planned, on November November 22, 1919, around 1,000 delegates attended, representing the original seven labor parties, as well as labor unions and new labor parties from throughout the country. The convention quickly elected Hayes as permanent chair of the party, John H. Walker as vice chair, and Frank J. Esper as national secretary treasurer. The keynote address was given by Chicago Federation of Labor leader John Fitzpatrick, who had been absolutely instrumental in the development of the party. The convention also adopted a declaration of principles which was patterned heavily on the Labor Party of Cook County's earlier 14 points of labor and a party constitution, both of which ultimately ended up surviving the Labor Party itself. Among the things demanded in the declaration of principles were the complete repeal of the Espionage Act of 1917, complete equality for all sexes and races, an end to labor injunctions, cost of living reductions, the nationalization of public utilities and natural resources, the enactment of the Plumb Plan to nationalize the railroads, free public education from kindergarten to university, and democratic education, the introduction of the powers of popular initiative, referendum and recall at the federal level, the abolition of the United States Senate, a maximum term of 4 years for federal judges, the introduction of a nationwide age of consent of 18 years, the abolition of the employment of all minors under the age of 16 years, the institution of minimum wages and minimum prices for agricultural goods, an end to the use of convict labor and foreign labor to undercut American workers' wages, a maximum work day of 8 hour and a maximum work week of 44 hours, and full employment merger. It was, however, clear from the beginning that, at least at this particular time, the interests of urban workers and rural farmers were so intertwined that they had really become one and the same. Moreover, the Labor Party, which was formed from the labor movement and thus had significant overlap with the industrial democratic tendencies of the Socialist Party of America, had a particular affinity for the idea of a cooperative commonwealth. All of these concerns fed into the establishment, on February 12, 1920, of the Cooperative Congress composed of members representing the Labor Party, the Committee of 48, the Nonpartisan League, and other groups of the farmers and cooperative movements. The Cooperative Congress was the first step toward the unification of the forces of labor, agriculture and cooperation. It elected, from among its quorum, a 12-member All-American Farmer Labor Cooperative Commission, which would concern itself with the task of paving the way for such a unification in July. Both the Labor Party and the Committee of 48 assembled their respective conventions in Chicago on July 13. The Committee of 48 convention joined the Labor Party convention to spectacular fanfare, and it was determined that the two would merge, retaining the Labor Party's constitution and principles, but adopting the new name of the Farmer Labor Party of the United States as a symbol of ultimate unity. The convention nominated a presidential ticket comprising Parley P. Christensen, the chair of the Committee of 48 Convention, as the nominee for president and Max S. Hayes as the nominee for vice president conventions. Convention location date notes and references. First National Convention Chicago November 22-25, 1919. Second National Convention also First National Convention of the FLPUS Chicago July 11-14, 1920. Merged with Committee of 48 to form FLPUS Officers. Chairman of the National Committee, Max S. Hayes. Vice Chairman of the National Committee, John H. Walker. National Secretary Treasurer, Frank J. Esper. Editor of the New Majority, Robert M. Buck. See also. Farmer Labor Party, United States American Federation of Labor, Committee of 48, Nonpartisan League, Socialist Party of America, Chicago Federation of Labor, John Fitzpatrick, Unionist State Affiliates, Minnesota Farmer Labor Party. References. Carrot Foner, Philip S. 1988 History of the Labor Movement in the United States, Postwar Struggles 1918-1920, New York, New York, International Publishers Co., Inc. ISBN. Carrot Goldstein, Robert Justin. 2001 Political Repression in Modern America. University of Illinois Press. ISBN. Major Parties. Democratic, Republican. Third Parties. Larger 1. Green Libertarian. Smaller 2. American 1969. American Freedom. American Populist. America's American Solidarity. Black Riders. Liberation. Christian Liberty. Citizens. Communist Constitution. Democratic Socialists. Freedom Road. Socialist Freedom. Socialist Humane. Independent American Justice. Legal Marijuana. Now Marijuana. Modern Whig. National Socialist Movement. New African Black Panther. New Black Panther. Objectivist Pacifist. Peace and Freedom. Pirate. Progressive Labor. Prohibition. Reform Revolutionary Communist Socialism and Liberation Socialist Socialist Action Socialist Alternative Socialist Equality Socialist Workers Unity Veterans Working Families Workers World World Socialist Former Parties America First American Know Nothing American 1924 American Nazi American Vegetarian Anti-Masonic Black Panther Boston Tea Citizens Commonwealth Land Constitution 1952 Constitutional Union Democratic Republican Farmer Labor Federalist Free Soil Gold Democrats Greenback Independence 2007 Labor 1919 Labor 1996 Liberal Republican Liberty National Republican National States Rights National Union 1864 Natural Law New Alliance New Union Nullifier Opposition Populist People's Personal Choice Progressive 1912 Progressive 1924 Progressive 1948 Raza Unida Readjuster Silver Silver Republican Socialist Socialist Labor States Rights Dixiecrat Unconditional Union Union 1936 Unionist 1850s, 60s U.S. Labor Whig Youth International 1 At least 100,000 registered party members nationwide 2 Fewer than 100,000 members state and local political parties without national body presidential nominating conventions Politics of the United States Politics Portal